Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Alicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. St. Lucia is updating its influenza preparedness plans as the coronavirus continues to spread. The World Health Organization reported on the new strain of the coronavirus in China on January 9, 2020. As of January 25, 1,320 cases confirmed. Of those cases, 1,297 reported from China, with 23 cases outside of China across 9 countries. Local health authorities have been working closely with international and regional partners as they provide guidelines to manage the virus. Dr. Sharon Belmer George, Chief Medical Officer, says that although the risk level for the Caribbean sub-region is currently classified as low and the disease is at an early stage of the outbreak, the Department of Health and Wellness will continue to monitor the coronavirus. In the interim, persons are asked to continue standard recommendations to prevent the spread of viral infections, which include washing of hands, covering your mouth and nose with disposable tissues or clothing when coughing and sneezing, as well as avoiding close contact with anyone showing symptoms of a respiratory illness such as coughing and sneezing. The Department of Health and Wellness has embarked upon the STEPS Behavioral Risk Factor Survey to monitor the causes and effects of chronic diseases. The survey, which began in December 2019, monitors behavioral risk factors such as smoking, alcohol consumption and unhealthy eating, as well as biological risk factors including high cholesterol levels, high blood pressure and obesity. Alma Dolo, Assistant Principal Nursing Officer at the Ministry of Health, is urging the public to cooperate with the enumerators and nurses during the data collection process. 71% of deaths worldwide are attributed to chronic diseases. In St. Lucia, 82% of the mortality rate is attributed to chronic diseases. Over $1 billion in recovery funding and in-kind services were recently pledged at a private sector pledging conference for Hurricane Dorian in the Bahamas. Hurricane Dorian, as a Category 5 storm, battered parts of the Bahamas in August 2019, leaving immense devastation and loss of life. The Office of the Prime Minister of the Bahamas, in a release following the conference, said the pledges included initiatives in home building and repair, educational assistance, renewable energy partnerships, relief aid, among others. In expressing his gratitude, the Bahamas Prime Minister, Honorable Dr. Hubert Minnis, said the conference was an important step in the ongoing reconstruction and rebuilding efforts. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.